I've mentioned before how down here in Pigeon Inlet we're trying to make a Canadian out of Pete Briggs. And Pete being the kind of man he is, 'tis not easy. But we've made a lot of progress, and early last fall we nearly hadn't won over. Skipper Joe swears that there at the school concert back in November, when we was all trying our best to sing O Canada, Pete's lips were actually moving. Skipper Joe can't swear if any words were coming out, but like we all agreed, the principle was the same. We'd made progress. And then to spoil it all, come this unfortunate business about John Cabot. The nerve of that schoolteacher, says Pete, to tell his youngster in school that perhaps John Cabot didn't discover Newfoundland after all, and that perhaps 'twas some place up on the mainland he discovered instead. What next, says Pete? We haven't got much left as it is, but take away John Cabot from us, and we'll have nothing. But I'm getting ahead of me story. Most of the arguments Pete used to use 2 or 3 years ago were so foolish that even Pete could see it, and had to give him up and try new ones. He even used to say he intended to buy the Newfoundlander because he was born a Newfoundlander. Grandma Walcott answered that one for him. She could remember the night Pete was born. And he might have been born a Newfoundlander, all right, she said, but he was an awful scrawny one. And he should thank his stars that he didn't bide like that. But it wasn't until Fisherman's Insurance come along that we had any real convincing argument to use on Pete. Because he had to agree with us that you got to have hundreds of thousands in a scheme like that to make it work. Skipper Joe reminded him how the lodge down here had tried an insurance scheme one time, and how Uncle Lige Bartle broke his leg in Capelin Skull and used up all the money we'd saved in 7 or 8 years. So Pete was coming around, slow. And that night, even if he didn't sing the words, and perhaps he didn't know them, anyway, his lips moved. And then, that unfortunate thing about John Cabot. Now, personally, I don't care whether John Cabot discovered Newfoundland or not. What I mean is, 'twas his own business. And whatever it was he did discover, there's nothing we can do about it now. So as far as I'm concerned, if anybody else wants John Cabot, they can have him and welcome. Jethro Noddy feels the same way. Only Jethro says perhaps the mainland wants him so bad, they'd be willing to pay a little something for him. Perhaps, he says, there should have been something about John Cabot put in term 29. But I tell him it's a kind of late to think about that now. And besides, when I mentioned to Pete Briggs the possibility of selling John Cabot, it made him madder than ever. Now, the trouble started just before Christmas, when Pete's little girl, in doing her history exam, said, naturally enough, how John Cabot discovered Newfoundland in 1497. The teacher, she's a young thing just out of college in St. John's, and right bursting with book learning, she put a question mark after it. And next day, Pete went up to the school and asked her what did she mean by questioning something that every Newfoundlander knowed as well as his own name. He says she tried to brazen it out by saying as how the history experts nowadays were beginning to figure that it wasn't Newfoundland at all that John Cabot discovered, but some place up on the mainland. Well, Pete was fit to be tied. Pete asked her how stunned did they think John Cabot was not to discover Newfoundland when it was right there in his path? Or did they think he just said, oh, there's Newfoundland. I got half a mind to discover it, but no, on second thoughts, I think I'll sail around the end of it and discover the mainland instead, because that's bigger. Now, Pete would have said more, only about then he choked up. Anyway, he come home, vowing he'd never send his youngster to that teacher again to get corrupted. Now, it puzzled me and Grandpa and the rest of us as to just why Pete was so worked up. After all, Cabot is not a relation. As far as we know, There's no connection between the Briggses and the Cabots, not even by marriage. So I took it on myself to find out. Pete, I said to him one day, when there were just the two of us, what odds about John Cabot? He looked like he wished he had hair on his head so's it could bristle. What do you mean, Uncle Mose, he said, what odds about John Cabot? Why, said I, let's face it. If they want him up there on the mainland, we can't save him. Uncle Mose, he said, John Cabot was the only bit of history I learned in school. There was another bit about a fella named Jack something or other, but I never did get that straight. So if I lose the bit about John Cabot discovering Newfoundland in 1497, t'll mean I made a complete water haul, and that's hard to swallow. And he's still finding it hard, 'cause only last night, when again we were doing our best to sing O Canada at the Women's Association concert, I took good notice of Pete's lips. There wasn't a biver in him. It looks like we got to start all over again.